Welcome to this short video where we'll show you how to use Quickroute to adjust your tracking for a headcam orienteering project. First, we'll open a new project and import the map and the GPX or fit file for the tracking. I've prepared the map and you can just take a picture with your phone, scan the map, or just get a JPEG from the course setter. That was the map, and then I'll just need to import the tracking, and as I use a Garmin watch, I'll need to import a fit file, just like that. And you'll quickly notice that the tracking doesn't follow the course exactly, and that's why where we just need to use the adjust route tool in the top left, and just simply drag the course, and we can just start by dragging the start and finish so that they fit, just like that. That helps a lot, and it all depends on how accurate you need to be for your project. I prefer to spend a little time adjusting all the minor things, but just go through the course, make sure that the controls fit as nicely as possible. Now that we have adjusted the course, we need to take a look at the split times. And the tracking comes with some built-in split times that are not accurate. So let's delete those first. And for that, we simply use the Add Split Time tool. And to remove things, we simply press Control and delete those split times that are already there. They don't really fit with the right split times. Just like that. And now it's just simply a job of adding the split times, the correct ones, at the various controls. We just simply keep adding split times. Control number 1, 2, 3, and so on. In the correct order, and just like that, last control, and you'll have 18 controls and 19 split times because you also have the time down to the finish line. Last thing we do is move the route line transparency tool all the way to the left, and now we're ready to export, and we simply need to export the image, the map. And just add a queue and image size 100%, image quality 80%. I'll export the GPX file. And the queue is just to distinguish it from the original. And then the root data in the XML file. Here we'll just need to check that you include the lap number, the time lap, and the route distance, and just like that. Now we have the files necessary for running a headcam orienteering project. So that's the next video. Thank you for watching.